Welcome back to Hand of Fate. Let's face the Queen of Dust.
Now we play for the cup, the first of my symbols. I've added some cards to spice up the game. In addition to the pain and gain decks, there are now blessings and curses. Choose your steps carefully.
Yeah, I saw quite a few rockfalls being added to the deck. So, we'll see exactly how good the things he added were. Oh, this should be a pretty easy one. Go ahead and enter, of course. Take that. Piece of pottery. I wonder if those things can actually engage the traps if they fell onto it. Nice, it didn't take any damage whatsoever.
A little gold. To give you a taste for it.
Hope I come across a shop now.
You might think the world of the cards is grim, yet even in the darkness, there is light to be found.
All right, well, plenty of health, plenty of gold. Let's go ahead and ask for some food.
I'm sure you are grateful for that. Goblins. I do love goblins. Truly, I haven't seen their like in years. Excellent.
Yeah, not so excellent for me. All right, let's kill the bastards. Yes, I took 17 gold and 3 food. Oh, I'm so slow. This is the money bags thing. Holy crap, I can't keep a lot of money on me. I'm way too slow. Oh, he's going to the portal. Yeah, so if I let him jump through that portal, he's gonna get away with my stuff. There we go. And yeah, it looks like you can actually still roll at full speed, so I think it's actually much faster to roll everywhere instead of running.
It's better than trudging along a muddy road. Certainly.
Hitch a ride. But to where? You found a friendly trader willing to let you ride on his wagon. Well, let's hitch a ride.
This game is still only beginning. New rules, new tools, new abilities. We have far to go as yet. These trails wind, and our goals wind with them. My voice and these words draw us closer to the inevitable conclusion.
Let's go ahead and fight the cowardly band once again. I gotta remember I have no shield. Also, my rusty axe is complete crap. Oh no, I got hit for the first time. Yeah, this axe is terrible. Oh crap, and I hit a trap. Great. Thank God, something a little bit better than my crappy old thing.
As pleases you.
Now at the moment I just really need a shield. And just as I say that, there it is. Ooh, I could also give him my gold. That would give me something better than just a shield, right? Because if I give him nothing and he gives me a shield, then he's gonna be pretty damn happy if I give him my money. And the money can actually slow me down. Yeah, let's do that and see what happens. I'm curious. Occasionally losing his place and moving different coins around randomly, he attempts to count the gold you place in front of him. This carries on for a while before he, quite calmly and deliberately, swallows each of the coins, one by one. Now, let's see what I have for you. Can you digest the metals contained in the coin? Mr. Lionel taps his staff on the ground and his shield materializes at your feet. Wait a minute, so giving him the gold did nothing?
Fling your opponent's challenges back in their faces.
I thought it'd be like a super special awesome shield or something. Well, damn.
Priests, gods, and eternal damnations. I have no truck with any of it.
This is a challenge. You meet a wandering priest who greets you in a friendly manner. For a small share of your provisions, I will bless you in the name of the old gods. Okay, yeah, I've got 12 food. Oh wait, give him half my food? Oh. Let's see what happens. Oh, okay, alright, got a huge success is the one I want.
A choice. Select your desire.
Alright, huge success was not the top card, so made it a bit hard to track. I think it's this one? Ah, damn, it's on the other side. Oh well. He says a few words in the language of the old religion and gently touches your forehead. It is done. One blessing card.
Blessings will remain always active and are never removed. Unless you die, of course. Then you're back where you began, as always.
Whenever the player uses an artifact, there is a 30% chance of immediately reducing its cooldown time by 80%. Well, at the moment, I don't think I have any artifacts, so I think this is completely useless.
Well done.
I don't have any, right? How would I check? Always active. Okay, so I guess it would be here? Yeah, there's my blessing, and there's my curse. In combat, the player's movement speed is reduced by how much gold they possess. Okay. Yeah, and that's my artifact slot, and I don't have any artifacts, of course. Okay.
Were you hoping this was the end? No. Another floor awaits.
Yeah, there's a couple places I didn't explore, but given that I only have 5 food, I can't really do that.
You are close on her trail, and more confident than I had imagined. Perhaps you will play beyond this mark, and we will see your true metal.
Looks like it's just a merchant, but the card is actually different from what I've encountered before, right? I don't remember finding this before. Priests have some skill in tending wounds, but they also excel at removing curses. For a price, of course. Well, I wouldn't mind getting rid of my curse. I should probably buy food, though. Yeah, I really should. Okay, what can I sell? Nothing! Remove curse, how much does that cost? 300? Oh my god. So, when he said these curses are permanent, he actually means that, right? Meaning when I go to play the next game, I'm still going to have the curse? Right? I'm assuming so, because if not, then how would you ever get enough money? Like, why would it ever be worth it to actually pay 300? If it only lasts for this one game. Alright, all of those are too expensive, so they don't matter. Alright, let's just buy some food. $14 food should be fine. Rockfall! Thank you for putting those in.
A terrifying walk to get to the Queen. So many potential places for an assailant to get the upper hand.
While journeying near the coast, you hear a rumble overhead. Falling rocks force you to take cover. Attempt to dodge the rocks. Is this gonna... Oh, of course. Okay, holy shit. Oh, they did it twice? I have no idea. I couldn't even track the top card, let alone... I don't even remember what it was. I think it was a failure. Who knows? Okay. Could have been worse. While fleeing, you are struck by several rocks. One pain card.
Oh dear.
A permanent injury.
Ouch.
Wait. Oh, I didn't even read that. Just when you think it's over, you hear, you are knocked unconscious by a large rock striking your unprotected head. A good warrior always wears a helmet, you remember. Hours later, when you awaken to find that some of your supplies are missing. Lose one food? Oh, that's nothing. That's fine. Yeah, no big deal.
Bandits, eh? Make an enemy of one, and you've made an enemy of all. One can't help but admire their single-mindedness.
Draw 3, inspect, and put back. How does that work? Oh, okay. Well, there's a queen of dust right there. Let's fight her.
Noble causes turn to rotten enterprise. You may win this battle and send the queen to her rightful end, yet what have you gained in the process?
This desert queen is more lethal in battle and harder to kill than a regular bandit. Her blades are sharp, and she is frequently protected by a powerful crossbow. The bandit queen was taken by slavers as a child and raised in the desert. Over the years, she was bribed and she has bribed and murdered her way to her current position as second in command of the desert thieves, proving herself capable of ruthless cunning. Yeah, so that frequently protected by a powerful crossbow thing, I think I've seen her fought before. I've seen people fight her before, and yeah, I think there's a pretty powerful crossbow that's just kind of stationary, and it just occasionally shoots at you. So I could either ignore it and just try to kill her as fast as possible, or I could go for it first. I might go for it first.
We play for a token now.
Yep, there's the crossbow. I'm gonna try going for it first, and let's see what happens. Okay, not going too bad so far. Oh, there we go. Okay. Should be easy from here on out. Ooh, that was close. Oh. Alright, three attacks, four attacks, not three. Okay, so you can kind of throw her red attacks off balance a little bit. There we go. Took a while, but that wasn't too bad.
Inevitable, I suppose. So often those who beat plowshare to sword die by the grim instruments of their industry. Still, she fought well and bravely, which is all I expect from my pawns and players.
Alright, so a bunch of stuff has changed. My counterattacks now do more damage, stun length is longer, new starting gear, thank god, hopefully this time I actually start with a shield. But the bandits and the skeletons have gotten stronger, and now the bandits have throwing knives.
You have earned the first of the symbols of my power and passed the first gate. There is no turning back now. Previously I was merciful, but now I cannot be. It is begun. I crafted each of these cards over the course of years, You have taken them from me in mere moments.
Huge hammer. That sounds really awesome.
Come, play again. Do you have what it takes to defeat the rats?
Curses twice the fail. The player loses 5 gold for every fail and 10 gold for every huge failure chance card. Oh, that's not too bad.
Ah, the rats. They have swarmed up from the dark places beneath the realms of humanity and now squat amongst your cities and feast and shriek and hunt and writhe.
All right, let's dump all of our axes and put in the new stuff. I think the maces are pretty good, right? Let's inspect. How much damage? Yeah, 27. The axes do 25, so this is better. Oh, so many new guards. I really don't have any particular reason to choose one over another, so let's just throw in a bunch of new ones. Maybe toss out a couple old ones, I suppose. Let's see what we have. Mr. Lionel, I think I'm gonna leave him in because I really like being able to get a shield, although if I start starting with a shield, then I guess I'll get rid of him because he'll be kind of pointless. Helpful Priest, let's ditch him. Winding Trail, let's ditch it. There we go.
Our Lord of Plague does like to rub your nose in misfortune.
That's a bunch of angry mobs. That music that happens right when a new game is starting is so exciting. It's like, get ready for a new adventure. This is kind of an awkward way to start. Because if I go the wrong way, I'm gonna have to go back to where I was before and trace back my steps. Could waste a lot of food.
Roaming ever forward, hunting for the truth.
This is a new one. Your path forwards will take you into the forest. You have discovered the exit. Oh, this is the exit. So yeah, I suppose part of a strategy is that, in terms of whether you actually want to go and go to the next level or stay where you're at, I suppose that's kind of a balance between how likely you think you are to take damage from the encounters that you'll find, how badly you need equipment, and how much food you have. Because if you have a lot of food, then you can kind of go back to areas and you don't really have to worry about it too much. And if you feel like you're ill-equipped for the end boss, then you're probably going to want to spend more time traveling around looking for better equipment. I feel like I'll be leaving too soon if I go now, so let's actually go back. Although if I don't find any food, I'm probably going to be in trouble.
Running water protects against many things in myth. Generally, though, it's just a pain to get past.
Your path is blocked by a river. The water is clear, but fast flowing. Let's try to cross. I think I lost it. Okay, the top card I believe was failure, and I want to say it was here. Nope, that was huge success. Your light armor makes the crossing relatively easy. You reach the other side, cold and wet, but unharmed. Interesting, does that imply that if you had heavier armor, this would actually be tougher to do? Because it specifically mentions the fact that I have light armor. Oh, I guess I don't actually get anything for that except that I completed the token? Or did I? No wait, it's not in the bowl. Did I need huge success for that?
A quest that may lead you down many paths towards jealously guarded secrets. Interesting.
You come across an injured adventurer whose battered and bloodied armor tells you he's seen combat recently. Let's ask him his troubles. I've been chasing a pack of thieves that attacked my home village of Embertown. I killed some of them in an ambush, but I fear I lack the strength to chase the rest down. If you have any honor, you will find those jackals and make them pay. Wait, so what does that mean? Is that like a blessing curse kind of thing? No? Oh, I think that just means that somewhere on the next level I might find that encounter or something like that. Yeah, anyway, I have to go. I'm really low on food.
An expedition. Press on. Each of these cards is crafted from your memories and built from your experience. I created them, but only in the abstract. It is the importance you place on them that makes them real.
Alright, I don't have any gold whatsoever or anything to sell, so I'm just gonna pass it by. Also, do I start with a shield? Yeah, you do. Okay, cool. And, oh, and you also start with an axe instead of a rusty axe. Okay. Nice. Alright, I have to keep going forwards because I really badly need food. Alright, that's kind of useless. Oh wait, is this different? This is different. He didn't make a shield materialize. Oh, is that because he knows I already have a shield? Here, Mr. Lionel pulls out a large, empty cloth sack and holds it open for you. Reach in and you will receive your heart's desire. Creepy mofo. Ooh!
A shield for the marathon, not the sprint.
Every third encounter does not consume food. Well, that's good. Press B button to shield bash a target, stunning it. Wow, that thing is huge. Cool. Alright, I'm gonna start starving to death now. Try to get the weapon. There we go. I followed the top card. This one was the top one, and it is success. Okay, minor damage upgrade from 25 to 27.
A horse is a fine companion. I'm sure you'll leave this one in time. You do not seem to have the temperament for friends, even in the animal kingdom.
All right.
Hush! Can you hear the way his claws scratch the tiles?
Ew. Alright, next move, I think I'm going to lose 10 health. Yep.
The deeper you go, the greater the risk of starvation.
Wait a minute, don't the goblins steal your food and gold? I don't have any. There's nothing for them to steal. Oh, they run away with a piece of my equipment. And they've also stolen some of my non-existent food and gold. Okay, so I'm actually gaining supplies by doing this, which is excellent. That was so easy. Yeah, I gained 18 gold and 4 food. I guess I was golden food that they stole from other people. Certainly wasn't mine. Should be able to buy a little bit of food. Anything to sell? Yeah, I can sell my old axe. There we go. One food. That's it. Ratman.
Now you begin to trespass upon the Ratman's hunting grounds.
You stumble upon a Ratman hunting party. Prepare to defend yourself. 8 rats, okay. That's a lot of enemies. Alright, I can do this.
Plague by name, and plague by nature. The rats leave behind a deadly toxin.
They're very fast. Oh shit, there's traps, great. Oh my god, this is a fucking clusterfuck. Shit. Ah. I'm taking crap tons of damage. I think I'm going through their like clouds of poison. I keep getting hit by fucking projectiles. Son of a bitch, I'm almost dead. I died to a trap. All right, I'm not used to fighting those fucking bastards. They're
and
fast.
And so the game takes another life. Do not worry, though. You may try again. Death in the home of plague. Once more, the cards will be dealt and fate will be decided.
Damn, that was a lot of enemies. Alright, I need to get better at, well, I think the tactic I started using towards the end was actually working very well, of kind of just kiting them all in one direction and just hitting one and then dodging, hitting one, dodging. Now, I could do the counters, but they attack so fast that your actual window for countering is pretty low, and when you're surrounded by maybe 3 at the same time, it's really hard. So I think a combination of doing my tactic of kind of just kiting them around, and also paying more attention to when I need to reflect arrows and other projectiles, I think I should be okay if I do that, because I was really bad at reflecting the arrows.
You face one of the fiercest of the Ratmen. I would wish you luck. But we play with fate. What brings you to play the game? Ha! I know you will not tell me. Like all the rest, you are silent.
Well, this is a much more favorable beginning in terms of being efficient for food use. Don't have any weird dead ends. Thank you. ice. Equipment with his trade is imbued with glacial power. Lizardmen are especially susceptible to ice damage. Each hit slows the target with cold. Press left bumper to shoot a cone of ice. Ooh. I'm probably completely gonna forget that, but that sounds really cool. Left bumper, that's a weird button to use.
Let's find out what type of character you really are.
Well, that was quick. You've caught up with the Embertown Village Raiders, who call out, "Stay your hand, adventurer, and we will share the spoils with you." Hell no! Refuse to deal with the thieving scum. You tell them to ask their gods for more mercy than you're about to show them. The card's kind of red. I assume that means it's more difficult than normal? Oh my god! This weapon is amazing! This would be so good for the Ratman. I could freeze a bunch of them. You carefully turn out the thieves' pockets.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Provides good protection against physical harm with minimal restriction on movement. Okay, so slight reduction to movement speed, but that's fine, I think.
Armor protects you from damage. The best armor, of course, does so much more.
Afterwards, you return to tell the hero of Embertown of your success. He gestures for you to come closer. In barely more than a whisper, he relates the location of an ancient treasure hidden in the Valley of the Hill Giants. Then, he dies. Poor guy.
Better than trudging along a muddy road, certainly.
Hello! He's gonna have me put my hand in his mysterious bag again? Oh, this is different. Mr. Lionel taps the table with his staff and some plump cakes appear in front of you. Remember, boy, when someone asks whether you'd like cake or pie, tell them you want cake and pie. I like this guy. I have no money, but I might have something to sell. Yeah, let's go ahead and sell my axe. You know what I don't understand, though, is how come some things disappear when they get replaced with something else and other things don't? Like, Frostfang replaced my axe, so I can sell my axe and it's just left in my inventory, but the medium armor replaced my light armor. And where did my light armor go? Is it just considered too big of an item to actually keep? So it just discards it? I don't think I'm going to be able to buy something for 3 gold. Nope.
Funny little fellows.
I can just freeze them in place and beat their sacks. The sacks on their back, of course. Jeez. What'd you think I meant? Oh, wait. Whoa, oh, they stole my Frostfang. Give me my sword back, you son of a bitch! There we go. Did I get my weapon back? Okay, I did. If I had lost that thing to some motherfucking goblins, and I had to go back to my rusty axe, I would have been so pissed.
One more step down, and we may see the end of this, or another set of stairs.
Two of dust, no problem. As long as it's not eight ratmen. Alright, I have plenty of health, plenty of food. Let's ask for some gold. Oh wait, I can ask for a blessing. Yeah, let's get a blessing. By whatever strength my people yet hold, may you be protected on your journey.
Useful.
Whenever the player is struck by a ranged attack, there's a chance that the attacker will be stunned for 3 seconds. Excellent. The elders of our kind often say that we must retread paths we once took in order to gain an advantage on the present. Farewell, mortal.
Work your way through the woods and see what lies beyond. Did you expect me to tell your fortune? No. A fortune teller is at their most base and despicable when they begin to believe their own lies. Of course, I am different. My powers are genuine.
You know, I actually believe you because you do seem to have the strange power to just make cards, like, just make them float in the air. So you seem to have some sort of telekinesis. Alright, there's a bunch of dead ends here. Thankfully, I have a bunch of food. Because I'm not sure which way I'm supposed to go. Only thing I can afford is a shield. And I've already got one.
So quick to anger. That's what makes them a mob, really.
As you approach the small town of... As you approach the small town of Witchburn. There's an angry mob in Witchburn, you don't say. An angry mob of peasants marches forth and confronts you. The ratmen have eaten all our food. We're starving. We demand food. I'm not giving you my food. Let's try to avoid the crowd. You turn about and head away from the crowd. Get him, somebody cries. Oh, that's so cool! Okay, so you can try to run, which I'm assuming would be one of those car challenges where you have to pick the right one. but I can also use my Frostfang weapon to slow them down. I had no idea that actually existed in the game. I don't know if that's something that I just don't remember being there, or maybe it wasn't in when I first saw this when it was in early access. So yeah, it's not just random encounters and random chance in doing those card challenges, but the equipment that you have can actually be used during the encounters. That is incredibly cool. Yeah, let's slow them down. Waves of magical cold sweep over the crowd as you unleash your Thurgy. Stunned and freezing, the peasants can do little more than watch your rapidly retreating form. Yeah, if you ever be ever find yourself being chased by an angry mob from Witchburn, just put them on ice.
At its heart, these traveling shows are but mockeries of the true mysteries.
One day, just as dusk gathers, you reach a large country town hosting a traveling circus. Strange sights and stranger smells confront you as you begin to wander between tents and stalls that were once brightly colored, but now are faded and stained with dust. Peasants and nobles alike wander the streets and alleys, past wonders and amazements, seeming almost dazed. There's something about the place that dulls your senses, and for a while, you forget your quest. Forget even the path that brought you to this place. Uh-oh. I don't know. Hey! Cheers and gasps draw you to a tent. Inside, you discover a number of spectacles being performed by costumed artists. Oh, again?
Choose from these options.
Oh, no! To one side, a pair of women dressed as devils periodically breathe fire into the air. One of them sneezes as you pass by, catching you in a burst of fire. The healer draws you one health pain card. God damn it. Lose 10 health. Oh, it's okay, so I'm not losing max health. That's fine then, because I can make that up in just two moves. Sometime later, you find yourself standing at the edge of a forest. The sounds of the crowds behind you. Day is just dawning. But which day? Looking back, you see the ruined buildings of a country town. Long ago abandoned. What? Was it the spirit of a carnival that I just witnessed? From long ago? That's creepy. Ah, looks like I didn't get the token. I guess I needed maybe two huge successes, or maybe just no massive loss. I'm not sure. Oh God.
They will not let you pass so easily. Prepare yourself.
Alright, I need to freeze them, and hopefully this time I don't draw 8. Come on. Okay, yeah, I can deal with that. Wait, I have no shield. Took 3 hit points of damage. Yeah, did I like just forget that I had a shield or what? What's up? Did it get stolen? I don't remember. Was it last life that I had a shield? I'm confused.
A horse is a fine companion. I'm sure you'll leave this one in time. You do not seem to have the temperament for friends, even in the animal kingdom. The Jack of Plague has bettered you once. Can you set him free this time?
You see an ancient, ornate coffin in the main burial chamber. It may hold spectacular wealth, but it will surely be guarded. Skulls. Okay. I can deal with them. I really want a shield before I face the end boss, though. Okay. Yeah! Suddenly, you leap into the fray, taking one of them down before they can even react. Oh, choose a monster to discard. Okay, cool. Well, this is gonna be really easy. That was the wrong button. Draw two, select one to keep. Oh, cool. What does the healing cap do? Doesn't say. Well, a huge hammer wouldn't be bad. Wait, is healing cap the one that increases the amount that you get healed by things that heal? So things that heal you normally would now heal you more? Nah, I'm going with the huge hammer. 35 damage.
Sometimes form follows function, and vice versa. In this case, it's called a huge hammer. You take a guess.
As you string together consecutive attacks, you do greatly increased damage. Press left bumper to unleash a force explosion. I like my freezing thing, but this thing sounds really freaking awesome. Let's equip it.
Really? Is that what you're going to do?
Nice.
Once loosed upon the lands, the rats will find you, no matter where
you go. Oh boy, and I have no shield. Okay, I'm gonna have to use this force explosion to hopefully just blow them up. In fact, maybe I'll just kite them until I can use it again. Oh shit, there's a trap. Oh god, there's traps everywhere! That was really bad. I think it's the traps that really do me in, to be honest. Because I try to be really maneuverable and just dodge everywhere, but then I just keep constantly hitting traps, and they do like 10 damage apiece. Fuck. Alright, I feel like I'm gonna fight the boss by the end of this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm actually gonna gain a little bit of health just by going back and forth.
I'm sure it's not called Dead Man's Gorge without reason.
No problem, it should be easy. It's really the Radmen are the only ones that actually give me trouble, and that's because I typically fight... Well, they have a lot of ranged weapons, I have no shield, they leave clouds of poison behind, they're fast attacking, they're just really... They're way more difficult than any other enemy I've encountered so far. Alright, I'm going for the range guy first. Thank God.
More health to work with. Much good meat, do you?
Thank God. Okay. We're saved.
Once the ratmen begin to creep towards the edge of the town, anger follows shortly behind.
Well, I don't have my frosty weapon anymore. Well... No, I actually do still have it, I just don't have it equipped. Do you think I can still use it during this encounter? Let's find out. Nope, I can't. Okay, here we go. I have no idea. Yep. The angry mob swarms around you. Their desperation for food overcomes their fear of your weapon long enough to get what they want. 5 pain cards! Ooh! That hurts. Okay, that doesn't matter. Whatever. Eh.
Oh dear.
What am I going to lose? What did I lose? The equipment is the only one I'm worried about. What the hell did I lose? I've got my shield. I lost my hammer. But that's okay, I have the Frost Fang, which is also really good. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Although, knowing how much you lose, next time I might just give him the food. There's no point stopping by, I have no gold and nothing to sell. Is this the final encounter?
He awaits. Plague. And pestilence. And blood. And... teeth.
Faster and stronger than normal ratman, this beast inspires all vermin around him to strike faster, the more damage he sustains. Here is a beast who hates your kind, and has grown fat and evil with that hatred. The Jack of Plague will kill you and suck the marrow from your bones. Alright, so he inspires all vermin around him to strike faster the more damage he sustains. So that sounds like I should kill the people around him before killing him, otherwise I'll end up buffing all of the other enemies. Yeah, so let's take out the ads before going for the boss.
Again, a token is at stake.
Come here, you ranged son of a bitch.
Ah! Alright, I think we're good. Yep, we're good. Get frozen, mofo! Oh, you can't. Okay, you can't freeze bosses. Gotcha. I think he's getting angry. Yeah, that does nothing. Ooh. All right.
The queens and kings of the rat kind have lost a child here today. Your prize. For slaughter, your reward.
Scorching Zeal. And Berserker Armor. These just... I just want to try all these things out. They sound so cool. Yay! More Ratman huntings.
Come, play. I do not want to just sit here. Now we play. You can now access Endless Mode, if you wish to test your skills against chance itself.
No thanks, I think I'm good. Alright, let's go ahead and assemble our deck and then end the episode. Let's see, curses. Compensation. Whenever the player finishes a combat, they lose 1 gold per 15 health. So, basically the better you do during combat in terms of taking less damage, the more gold you lose. That's pretty harsh.
Some men thrive in anarchy and chaos. The King of Dust is one such. His tools are cruelty and terror, and I suspect he will harbor a great hatred for you, my friend.
Okay, I think I'm gonna get rid of the healing cap because I don't think I like it very much. Berserker Armor's new, that sounds cool. As is the Healer's Ring and Ring of Justice. Just throwing a bunch of stuff, I suppose. Oh wait, I'm already good on encounters. Yeah, apparently my encounters are fine, but let's throw out some old stuff anyway. Devil's Carnival. That was... Well, I haven't beaten the challenge yet, so I might not want to throw it away. Or have I? Wait, how do you tell? Like, this one has a lock on the top, and this one has a little symbol down below. What does that mean? I think that means I haven't done it yet. I don't know what this is doing. Token, new, not sure. Anyway, I'm gonna throw out the ones that I definitely know I've accomplished. Leave in Mr. Lionel. There we go. So yeah, I suppose with my deck, I'm not, for the most part, I'm not really strategizing what I include. I'm mostly just wanting to find new and interesting things. But there's definitely room for strategizing. I mean, I am a little bit in the sense that I'm leaving in Mr. Lionel because I want a shield. So I guess it's a little bit of strategizing. But for the most part, I just want to find new stuff. Okay, we are good to go to fight the King of Dust. But I'm going to save that for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.